Yeah, can you all see?
Yes, Mataji.
Okay.
63 days to go.
Are you counting down the days, Keshavi?
Wait, 63 also, days for what to be ended?
Also try to remember all the qualities, okay?
63 days for what to be ended.
So this session.
Okay, shall we start with the prayers? Let's all say the prayers. Om Agyana Timirandasya Gyananjayasalakya
Mataji, once could I say
Prasthaya Bhutale Shrimati Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharane Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shrivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinoda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Hare. Very good. Somebody was calling me. Someone wants to say something.
Mataji, could I say the Bhagavad Gita Om Agnana part of the prayer?
Which part? Who is that?
Moksha.
Moksha, which part, Moksha?
Like, could I just sing it?
Oh, those verses? Are you talking about verses?
I'll just sing the part I know, okay? Is that fine?
Which one, Moksha? Which one you're saying? I'm not understanding.
In the Bhagavad Gita, the prayer you start with Om Agnana Timirandasya.
Oh, we all said it all together now, right? You didn't say?
Mataji.
You didn't say with us, Moksha?
I did.
We did, right? Yeah, we always say it all together, okay?
Okay. Mataji, can I say the shloka on slide
3? What we will do, we will say it all together. Okay. Because there is a lot to cover today. Today is very interesting, okay? So if I give chance to all of you one by one, then that's going to take time, okay?
Hare Krishna Mataji, this is Ojasvi.
Hare Krishna Ojasvi. So I will say, you all repeat, and then all of you say it once, all together, okay? We will go like that. And then someone say the translation.
Mataji, is there usually just 19 people?
Actually, there is some problem also, no? In some of the places. There is power outage, there is no internet. So maybe that's why we have only 19 today. But right, that's okay. We have 19 today. That is also a good number.
Who could be watching?
Okay, so shall we all say the verses? I will say you repeat, okay? Katham vidyam aham yogi.
Katham vidyam aham yogi.
Aham yogi.
Tvam sada parichintayan.
Tvam sada parichintayan.
Keshu keshu cha bhaveshu.
Keshu keshu cha bhaveshu.
Chintyosi bhagavan maya.
Chintyosi bhagavan maya.
Very good. Can you all say it together once? Everyone in sync, okay? 3, 2, 1.
Katham vidyam aham
yogeshu chintyosi bhagavanmaya.
Yes. So now we have been reciting this for the past 2 days. Still, anyone has any difficulty in this?
No, Mataji.
Everyone is aware of these verses, right?
No, Mataji.
Okay. So someone can read the translation quickly.
Mataji, can Moksha
read? Mataji, can say the translation?
Okay.
Mataji, can Moksha say the translation,
Moksha, go ahead,
please?
Moksha. Go ahead, Moksha. Go ahead, Moksha.
O Krishna, O Supreme Mystic, how shall I constantly think of you? How shall I know you in what Various forms are you to be remembered, O Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Yes.
Mataji?
Yes?
Can Subhadra say the translation again?
Will you say this translation of the next verse, Subhadra?
Okay, Mataji.
Okay, so let's say the next verse. Please repeat. Adityanam aham Vishnur.
Adityanam aham Vishnur.
Jyoti Sham Ravirashuman.
Jyoti Sham Ravirashuman.
Marichir Marutam Asmi.
Marichir Marutam Asmi.
Nakshatranam aham Shashi.
Nakshatranam aham Shashi.
Can you all say it together? In sync, okay? Nobody is going fast. No one is going very slow. Okay? 3, 2, 1.
Adityanam aham Vishnu Jyotisham Ravirasuman Marichir Marutamasmi Nakshatranam aham Shashi.
Okay, very good. Anyone has any difficulty in this verse?
No, Mataji.
No, Mataji.
Everyone,
no, Mataji.
Okay? No, Mataji.
Okay, very good. Subhadra, can you read this translation?
Okay, Mataji. Of the Adaitas, I'm Vishnu. Of the lights, I'm the radiant sun. Of the Marututs, I'm Marichi. And among the stars, I'm the moon.
Yes. So here Arjuna is asking, right? How can I constantly think of you? How can I remember your form, various forms? So Krishna is telling how he is the best of all these categories. Okay, similarly, the next verse also goes the same way. So please repeat the next one, text 22 of chapter 10. Okay?
Okay, Mataji.
Vedanam sama vedosmi.
Vedanam sama vedosmi.
Devanam asmi vasavah.
Devanam asmi vasavah.
Devanam asmi vasavah.
Indriyanam manaschasmi.
Indriyanam manaschasmi.
Bhutanam asmi chetana.
Bhutanam asmi chetana.
Can you all say it together? 3, 2, 1. Very good. Everyone said it, right? Any difficulty in this verse?
No!
No, Mataji.
Very good. You all have become expert in this, right? Some might already know this, right? So, Krishna Naina, can you read the translation, please?
Okay, Mataji. Of the Vedas, I am the Samaveda of the demigods. I am Indra, the king of heaven, of the senses. I am the mind and in living beings, I am the living force, consciousness.
Yes, very good.
Mataji, who's the Supreme Lord? Because I'm getting confused. People say it's Vishnu and people say it's Krishna.
Here he says, I am Vishnu in Adityas. But from whom Vishnu comes?
Krishna.
Yeah, so Krishna is the Supreme, right? Krishna is the Supreme.
One of the chapter
you have. Yeah. So what are we learning this week? Can someone tell me what are we learning this week?
64 qualities of Krishna.
64 qualities of Krishna.
Yes.
Mataji?
Yes?
This is Subhadra saying, yes. like I was about to say something, like last class, did we learn the other shlokas?
No, the same shlokas we are reciting. All this day.
Okay, Mataji.
Mataji,
the Krishna.
Yes. Okay. So yesterday, which quality we learned? Anyone remembers?
Beauty.
Beauty.
Mataji, yesterday I wasn't there for class, so I don't know what we learned.
Okay, so but whoever is not joining that day, we always have videos available. You can have a look at it later whenever you have time. So yesterday we learned the quality of beauty of Krishna. The second quality is how Krishna is marked with all auspicious characteristics. Anyone knows this? What does it mean? Anyone knows? Jagannath, do you know?
Marks.
Ramachandra, do you know?
What it means?
Yes. Anyone has heard of it?
Mataji, what is the second quality?
Marked with all auspicious characteristics.
Okay, Mataji.
Okay, so let's see what is it, okay?
Mataji, is it beauty?
It's beauty we already heard, we learned yesterday, right?
What marks it has?
Let's see what it is. Okay. Here says there are certain characteristics of different limbs which are considered to be very auspicious and are fully present in the body of the Lord. So there are some characteristics or marks on the body or limbs of the Lord which are considered very auspicious. Mukund, can you please move? Thank you. So in this connection, one friend of Maharaj Nanda Maharaj, he was speaking to Nanda Maharaj, and he told when he was talking to him about Lord Krishna's auspicious bodily symptoms. He said to him, "My dear king of the cowherds," who's that? Nanda Maharaj. He was talking to Nanda Maharaj. "I can find 32 auspicious symptoms on the body of your son. I'm wondering how this boy could have taken his birth in a family of cowherd men." So generally when Krishna appears, usually appears in the family of Kshatriya, like Lord Ram, or in the family of Brahmanas. But here, where Krishna has taken birth? In the family of?
Cowherds.
Cowherds. So what is that? Which community is that?
Vaishya.
Vaishya, yes. So what is the business of the Vaishya community?
Tech cows, like farm and
trade, commerce, protection of cows.
Yeah.
So his friend was wondering, actually he should have been in Brahmana family or Kshatriya, but how he is born in this Vaishya family, but still he has all these auspicious characteristics on his limbs. So what are those? He further explains, what are those marks? So Krishna has, now these all characteristics start here, okay? Krishna has 7 parts red. What are those parts? Can someone read these 7?
Eyes, palate, lips, tongues, hands, feet, his nails.
Yes. So his eyes are red. Palate, do you know what is palate?
No.
No.
The mouth, the roof of the mouth. Here, that is red.
Oh, like the outside gum part.
Lips, here I think the palate is here. The roof of the mouth. Lips are red. Tongue is red. Hands. Our hands are red?
No.
Krishna's hands are red. Feet.
Hands are red.
And his nails. Krishna's nails are also red. Okay. Further he says, 3 parts are broad. What are those parts? Shri Krishna, can you read these parts? Which parts are broad? Shri Krishna?
You're muted.
Oh, chest, yes. Waist, and forehead?
Yes. So these 3 parts are broad.
Mataji, could I also say?
Yes. Oh, you want to read?
Okay. No, the 3 parts.
These ones?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
Chest, waist, forehead. And could I read the other one, like slide 8?
Okay, who is that?
Moksha.
Okay, Moksha. Shall we give others chance? There are many who have not said anything. Is that okay? Is that okay?
Yes. Mataji, can Subhadra and Giridhari?
Okay, yeah.
Who did not together?
Who did not
say anything?
I will give chance who did not say anything so far, not even translation.
Sanskriti. Mataji, can I?
So three parts are short. Sanskriti, can you read? I will say the call out the names and those can read, okay?
Genitals, thighs, and neck.
Yes. So these parts are short. So what are the broad parts? Chest, waist, forehead. And what are the short parts? Genitals, thighs, and neck. Krishna's neck is also short. His thighs are also short. And Harini, can you read? What are the parts? What parts are deep?
What parts are deep?
Yes. Can you say
this? Voice, intelligence, and navel.
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 These parts are deep. Okay. Five parts are high. Mukund, can you read these parts?
Yes, Matiji. Nose, arms, ears, forehead, and thighs.
Yes, his nose is high, arms are high, ears are also high. Krishna's forehead is high, and thighs are also high. Okay, are you all
in Mataji, what are the thighs?
Thighs, like part above the knees.
They're like part of your leg, like the top part. Where,
that one, okay.
You all can imagine, visualize how Krishna looks like. So what are the parts that are fine? Fine means what?
Like soft and like plain.
Best quality. Okay? So Atharva, can you read what are the parts are fine for Krishna?
Nails. Skin, feet, and hair, and skin hair.
Yes, yes. Krishna's nails are fine, they're top class. Skin, his teeth, his hair, and skin hair. They're all fine, top class, best quality. And five parts are like lotus. You always say, right? Lotus face, lotus eyes. What are those parts? Who didn't get a chance to say? Mokshit, can you say? What are the parts?
Eyes, face, hands, feet, and navel.
Yes. So these are lotus-like parts of Krishna.
Mataji?
Yes?
What is a navel?
Navel is...
It's like the belt button.
So
it's like the belly button.
The lotus sprouted, right? From Krishna, Vishnu's navel.
The belly button.
Belly button. Okay. So far everything is clear. So here that friend of Nanda Maharaj is explaining what all characteristics Krishna has, which are different, like which are auspicious. How Krishna has these seven parts red. These three parts broad, chest, waist, and forehead. These three parts are short, genitals, thighs, and neck. These three parts, voice, intelligence, and navel, these are deep. Five parts are high, nose, arms, ears, forehead, and thighs. And these five parts are fine. Nails, skin, teeth, hair, and skin hair. These five parts, eyes, face, hands, feet, and navel, are like lotus. So many times we hear this lotus, right? Lotus-like face or lotus-like eyes. Why we always hear that lotus? Why Krishna is compared to lotus? Anyone knows that? Anyone knows why lotus? Why not any other flower?
Because lotus is the best thing on earth. It's the most beautiful thing.
Vishnu has from his navel, he has a lotus flower, and Brahma.
The same as Krishna.
Daji?
I see some of you have raised hands. Is it from the previous time, like from verses?
Mataji?
Yes.
No, Mataji, it's for this time.
Yes, you can see
Mataji?
Yes.
This is Shubhadra and Giridhar speaking. I'm just saying that lotus are so special that Krishna is like super special.
Okay, that's
Mataji, I got a question.
Yes.
Can I show you this, what I did?
Who's that? Who's showing?
Is it Giridhar?
showing a picture.
I mean,
he's showing a picture.
This is Moksha. Could I do one last, please?
Okay, I can see Giridhari. Wow, it's beautiful. Very nice, Giridhari. Very nice.
Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you, Mataji.
So now I will tell you why Krishna is always compared to a lotus. What are the limbs that Krishna are compared to lotus? Just now we say, right? Here, eyes, face, hands, feet, and navel. We also say lotus feet, right? So in the scriptures, Lord Krishna is compared to many things. Two being prominent. Two are prominent ones. Which one? Lotus and full moon. Krishna is also compared with the full moon. The lotus is considered pure because in spite of growing in mud, the lotus grows in the mud, right? But still, it keeps its beauty intact. It's still very beautiful. That's why Krishna is always compared to lotus. Okay, so in reality, God cannot be compared to anything of the material world, right? Because everything in the material world comes under three modes. What are three modes?
Goodness, passion, ignorance.
So can we compare Krishna with all these things?
No.
No, because Krishna is beyond that, right?
Mataji, there is also pure goodness and that is above the three modes of material nature and he is above that also.
Yeah. Transcendental.
But to point out Krishna's various qualities and his greatness, scriptures and saints draw comparisons. Okay, so we know about his greatness and his qualities. So one basic question, why are we learning about Krishna's qualities? Anyone knows?
Then we'll be able to understand Lord Krishna.
Okay, that is one good reason.
Because he is so special.
Yes, Krishna is special, yes. Anyone has any other answer? Why are we learning about qualities?
Because then we'll become attracted to him.
Yes.
And then we'll know about him and we can know what he likes and all.
Don't know, Mataji.
So Krishna doesn't have just 64. These 64 are prominent ones. That's why we are learning about this. But Krishna has unlimited.
Yes, 64 common ones, right?
He has 64 qualities because we're learning.
Which we cannot even understand.
Main qualities, and then out of those 64, he has another 8 prominent ones, I think.
Mm.
Or is it 6?
So we're learning about qualities because we understand Krishna more and we get attracted. So if someone has good qualities, we get attracted to that, right? If someone is very good in intelligence, someone is beautiful, we get attracted. So Krishna, he displays these qualities so that his devotees get attracted to him. That is also his mercy when he shows these qualities. So we get attracted. So do you know whose feet are these?
Lord Krishna's or Radharani?
Which is Radharani's and which is Krishna? Anyone knows?
Mataji, the one with the
Mataji, they look very different.
Number one is
okay. Number one, who thinks please Krishna?
Mataji,
number two is Radharani.
Number one is Krishna's.
This is Radharani. Number two. How do we find it out? Because Radharani has.
Radharani has a fish and a temple and a swan and a.
And Krishna is represented as a moon. So moon is on his. And he has the chakra.
Yes. So these are the differences. There is
this
flower. For Radharani, there is this flower. There is this altar.
Everything is so cute and Radharani. And everything is so cute in Krishna's.
Okay.
That's the
norm. So that friend also says how Krishna has all these marks on his feet. So there is one verse. Can someone read the translation of this, which has all these marks on the feet of Krishna?
Mataji, can Ojaswi tell
in Sanskriti?
Can Akshita say? Can Akshita say?
Ojaswi, did you get a chance to say at all or no?
No, Mataji.
Okay, go ahead.
Chandratam kalash
translation.
I worship Lord Hari Krishna, whose feet are endowed with the 19 great appearances of on the left foot, the half moon, water pot, triangle, bow, sky, cast foot, hoofprint, fish, conch, and on the right foot, the eight-pointed star, the swastika, wheel, parasol, barley corn, elephant, goat, flag, thunderbolt, jamba fruit, urtva, reka, and lotus.
So let's see for the first left foot. What all it has? Left foot has half moon, water pots here. You can see the water pots, right?
Yes.
Then there is a bow. Sky. Cow's hoof print. These are the hoof prints.
Mataji, what's a hoof print?
Cow's footprint.
It's like a foot.
Footprint.
Like a footprint of the cow.
Yes.
What's a jet of foot?
Fish, corn, and on the right foot, this is Krishna's right foot, right?
But Mataji, why do they call it hoof foot?
Hoof print. It's called a hoof print for cows.
Like they can just call it footprint instead of hoof. The hoof looks different than a foot.
Yes, that is not foot, right?
Yeah.
That's right.
Because cow or hoof prints look different.
Yeah, horses, cows.
Okay, got it. Thanks.
Eight-pointed star. Do you see the eight-pointed star on the right?
Yes.
And there is swastika. Yeah. This is swastika. You might all know it. Then wheel. Do you see the wheel? Parasol. This is the umbrella. Parasol is umbrella. Barleycorn. Can you also tell me what is barleycorn here? So there is this one here. What? Barley corn. This is the mark. Elephant gold.
Our barley corn in Vrindavan.
Huh? Okay. Then flag. Thunderbolt. Jambu fruit. Urdhvareka. This is the line. Do you see this line here? That's Urdhvareka and lotus.
In Sanskrit, this line.
Oh, okay.
Okay, everyone got these marks?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
Yes.
Let's see what are the meanings of this mark. So, okay. Half moon. Where do we see half moon?
Shiva.
Yes, Lord Shiva has the half moon, right?
Shiva.
So half moon. This mark symbolizes how lotus feet truly provide the desired objectives of the devotee. Signifies that even devatas like Lord Shiva can you all please mute? Okay.
Mataji?
Yeah.
Yes. This is Shubhadra speaking. I'm saying that Shiva has like it's like a half moon. It looks like a crescent moon.
Yes. Yeah, it is he has like a crescent moon right on his hair, and then there's also water coming out of his
We see the half moon on the lotus foot of Krishna, we just saw. So that's why Krishna, Lord Shiva has it on his head. It's like having Krishna's foot on his head.
Oh.
Okay. It also shows that...
Yeah. What? Like having Krishna's water on his head.
So it's like they decorated their own heads with the soles of the feet. It's like having the sole of the feet.
Wait, on Krishna's foot is there... Oh, there is a crescent moon on Krishna's foot.
Yes, there is. Half moon is there, right? You saw this half moon?
Uh-huh. That's why Shiva's wearing a half moon.
Yes, got it? Yeah. It also shows that devotees who likewise decorate their own hair with the feet exalted like Shiva. Just as the moon showers nectar with its cooling rays, similarly the lotus feet shower nectar upon the devotees. So why we have to meditate on the moon shape of on the feet foot of Krishna? because how moon showers the nectar with its cooling rays, right?
Mataji.
Similarly, lotus feet shower nectar upon the devotees.
Mataji.
Yes.
Could you go back to slide 16?
Okay.
I'm just seeing. Oh, is there sun on Krishna?
It's like sky. So moon is one, yet it destroys the darkness seen by many people simultaneously. Similarly, the Lord is one, and yet by his cleverness can deliver many souls at the same time.
Mother, yesterday there was a crescent moon.
Yes, it's, yeah.
Actually,
half moon.
Crescent moon.
Yes. So, did you understand some of the reasons what it signifies? Yeah.
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
Okay. Yes, Mataji.
So when
yes, Mataji.
When we think of half moon on the foot of Lord Krishna, we can get these things in mind. What it signifies, okay? We can think of Lord we can think of Lord Shiva, how he has decorated his head with the half moon, or we can think that how moon showers the nectar.
Mataji.
Like Krishna's lotus feet also shower the nectar upon devotees. Next is water pot. So you see the water pot here? Yes.
Why is Prana?
Mataji, I see the water pot.
Mataji, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
Somebody was saying something?
Why is Pranav host? Pranav is host, it says
because mother is
Oh, okay.
Because their mother is there.
Mataji, there's like a problem, that's why Pranav is the host. I saw that yesterday.
Mataji, can you hear me?
Yes.
This is Shubhadra speaking. I'm saying that at slide 16 in Krishna's feet, it has the water pot.
Yes, it has water pot. So
see. Mataji, could I see Radharani's feet for a second, please?
Okay, so water pot, what does it signify? This mark shows that lotus feet hold the golden pitcher full of purely nectarian ambrosia to be freely consumed by the surrendered souls. Indeed, they will never be bereft of nectar, for this pitcher always remains full. So this shows that the lotus feet of Krishna always hold the nectar, lot of nectar, and which never gets over, which is always there for the devotees, which is always full.
Mataji, I noticed on Radharani's feet there is a moon also.
Yes, they both have some of the common marks.
Like
some are different. Okay. This also indicates that the feet can pour out nectar that extinguishes the blazing threefold miseries. So we have a lot of miseries, right? So these feet can pour out the nectar, and that's what this signifies, the water pot. Rather, the feet bring ripples of happiness emanating from divine auspiciousness. So what we have to think when we see the water pot, what we can think of? The nectar.
The nectar.
Nectar, yeah, which can take away all the miseries.
Misery.
Okay. Yes, somebody is saying something?
The same thing about Krishna is the fish. There are like many things, but I don't want to talk about it.
Okay. Actually, there are many points here, but I don't know if we have time.
Yeah.
All are given here. Elephant, goat. See that, do you know the how elephant is controlled?
Yeah.
Elephant, goat, Ankusha. So that marks that it signifies that it controls and keeps our mind. Controls our mind.
Oh, it's like Mataji.
Flag. Meditating on it, they give security and safe protection. When we see the flag, we have to think that gives security and safe protection. So there are yes.
Like, can you go to the elephant thing?
Okay.
Like, you said something in the end, so like at the same way, this can be like
we're the elephant and Krishna's like the housekeeper. Like we can get all like cut. He's like our master. Like, yeah. I don't know.
So when we go to temple, you all know, right, how we should take the darshan of Lord Krishna. Where should we start looking at him? We should always look at his feet first.
Feet.
We should look
like,
at
like.
So when
feet.
We
then look, we slowly go up.
So when we look at Krishna's feet, we all can think of all these marks from.
Yeah. The, so should we? So we go like look at the feet, and then we start looking up and up and up.
Up and up. Yeah. Then thighs, then chest, then face. Then when we look at Krishna's feet, from next time we can think of these marks. We can meditate on them so that we can Krishna can take away all these miseries and everything away. Okay, I wanted to cover everything, but I don't think we have time. I think you have cooking class today. Mataji,
Mataji, are you cooking, yeah. Mataji, or another person?
Mataji,
Mataji,
you can take more.
Is
10 minutes,
okay.
Like
is
8 o'clock is okay?
Yeah. Yes, Mataji.
Okay, Mataji. So let's look at the bow. Okay. There is this mark bow. Where do you find this bow? It's here on the left foot.
Left foot.
Signify, this mark reveals that those who take shelter of the lotus feet will be perpetually free from all worries and difficulties. So what it signifies, if we meditate on this, if we take the shelter of lotus feet of Krishna, what it will do, it will be perpetually free from all worries and difficulties. It also shows that those who are stupefied in the material world remain motionless like a target and do not come to lotus feet. Whereas those who come to the ultimate goal of the feet remain there and never go back to the material world. Further, when the mind of the devotee meets the target of the feet. So what is our target? What it says?
So with the bow, we
target something, right? With bow and arrow. So that's why here it's talking.
So does that mean that we target to go back to Krishna?
Krishna's feet is the target for the devotees. Then prema condenses as a result and overflows as the tears showering from their eyes.
Mataji?
Yes?
Can I say something? This is Giridhari saying.
Yes, go ahead.
The bow, Ramchandra always he always used the bow always.
No, Raman loves
always carried bow. Yes, he always carried bow.
Mataji, this is
Shubhadra. Yes.
Mataji, this is Shubhadra speaking. I'm saying that Ram and Lakshman have the bow and they have the arrows in the patch.
I never knew I actually had a bow.
So what sky signifies that Krishna is all pervading within and without.
Mataji.
All manifestations. It also shows even though the feet are everywhere, they are unattached just like the sky.
Mataji, sorry to interrupt, but
go ahead, ask. What happened? Okay, so there are cow's hoof prints, right? So what they signify? Who have taken full shelter of uninterrupted meditation on the feet, the great ocean of worldly existence becomes very small. We all must have heard of this, right? The miseries are like ocean. But it becomes like a small hoofprint of cow if we take shelter of Krishna. And then very small and insignificant, like the water held in a calf's hoofprint and is thus easily crossed over. So water in the cow's hoofprint can be easily crossed over, right? But can ocean be crossed over easily?
No.
Our miseries are like ocean, but how it becomes small, like a cow's hoofprint? When we take shelter of Krishna's lotus feet.
In bhakti yoga, if we do bhakti yoga, then we can approach Lord Sri Krishna.
Yes. So fish, there is another one, fish. So where is this fish here? Here, on the left.
It's on the left
end. In the end.
But
this mark shows that just as a fish cannot live without water, right? Fish cannot live without water. Similarly, the surrendered devotees cannot live a moment without directly associating with the feet. Surrendered devotees cannot live without the feet, associating with the feet of Lord Krishna, just like fish cannot live without water. Okay? It also shows that all the most cherished desires and longings of those who resort to lotus feet will be truly fulfilled. And mind is very fickle, just like fish, right? Who wavers this way and that. And so only after much meditation do the feet finally come into the heart. It also indicates that lotus feet will come to live in one's heart only if the heart has been liquefied by soft, loving emotions. The feet do not thrive where it is dry. Okay? Even if you keep one thing in mind of all these marks, and if you meditate on them, when you look at Krishna's lotus feet, then Krishna will be very much pleased. Okay, and we next we have conch. This auspicious, so when do we use the conch shell? When Krishna used the conch shell?
In the
Mahabharata. Yes.
Mataji?
Yes.
In the Bhagavad Gita, like a different Bhagavad Gita, another English Bhagavad Gita, not like ours, but it's like different, that Krishna is putting the conch in his mouth and he's blowing it, and Arjuna is in the chariot.
Yes, okay. At the time of war, right? Kurukshetra.
Kurukshetra war.
So what it signifies?
Blowing
of conch shell, it also means victory, right? So this symbol proclaims ultimate victory for devotees.
Mataji,
I have a question. This is Keshav.
Yes, Keshav.
Mataji, this is Shubhadra speaking, Mataji.
Yes.
I'm saying that first someone will say something, then I will say something. Because I heard someone...
Shall we say it is in the end? Let me finish this first. Is that okay?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
Okay. So how this is blown at the time of victory? So this symbol proclaims ultimate victory for the devotees. Since the conch shell mark on the feet contains the entire ocean of material existence that may now be easily crossed. Same like cow's footprint, right? This mark also shows that those who resort to lotus feet become completely fearless. So those who take shelter of Krishna's lotus feet become completely fearless.
Yes. Mataji,
I'm sorry to interrupt, but Arjuna also blew his conch shell in the war.
Mataji, this is Shubhadra speaking. I'm saying that
Mataji, sorry to interrupt, but who won the Mahabharata war?
Pandavas. Okay, there's also disc. This marks down the six enemies.
Mataji.
What are the six enemies? Shubhadra, shall we speak after this, please?
Yes, Mataji.
This. Thank you, Shubhadra. So this mark, which is disc chakra, Sudarshan chakra, you all know that, this, right? So this cuts down six enemies. What are the six enemies? Lust, anger, greed,
illusion, envy, and bewilderment.
Yes. So this you can keep in mind when we see the chakra on the lotus feet.
Mataji, I just had...
We already discussed this flag. We discussed.
Mataji.
This mark reveals that meditation on lotus feet smashes to pieces the mountain of devotees' karmic reactions. So what it does, it smashes the karmic reaction of the devotees to past sins. That signifies thunderbolt. Then lotus, umbrella, yes. Go ahead.
In the 64 qualities, which quality is this? Is it like...
It's the second one. These are the marks on the limbs of Krishna.
marks
are discussing. These are the marks on the lotus feet of Krishna. And in the beginning, we also discussed how Krishna is, five parts are fine, how five parts are high.
Okay. Oh, Mataji, wasn't it the auspicious qualities of Krishna?
These are characteristic marks on the limbs of Krishna.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so these are all the marks, and I think most of them we have covered, and I think it's time. So are you all ready for cooking?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
Thank you all for your patience and listening nicely. All of us so good. Thank you.
Thank you, Mataji.
For the class.
Thank you very much, Mataji, for the class. See you in 9:50.
Are we done or are we having a cooking class?
Hare Krishna.
Mataji is giving us cooking class today. Radhika Mataji.
Radhika Mataji.
Oh, Hare Krishna, Radhika Mataji.
Hare Krishna, kids. How are you?
Hare Krishna, Radhika Mataji.
Good, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, everybody.
Hare Krishna.
So today we are making a simple salad, okay?
Mataji, what are we making today?
Are we making?
Yeah, we are making with a moong dal salad. Can you all hear me?
Oh, we're making
yes,
with
Mataji.
Mataji, Mataji, what are we making?
Some salad.
Did you able to? Yeah. Mataji, did you able to soak the moong dal? This moong dal.
Mataji, we didn't soak the moong dal yet, so we'll be doing it tomorrow or some other time.
Okay, okay. Yeah, I'll show you. This is very simple one, okay?
Mataji, will
Mataji? Mataji?
So the ingredients we need for these are? So shall I show you the ingredients? We just need some grated carrot, okay? And some, we need small pieces of cucumber. You can grate it or you can make a small pieces.
Mataji,
and some fresh coconut.
If we don't have coconut,
don't need. If you don't have, don't need to. It's an optional actually. Okay.
Thank you.
If you have, you can use it. I'm just using little salt, pepper, and coriander leaves, and some lemon. Okay. Planter bottle. And if you want, you can use some nuts also. Okay.
Okay.
So you can take one plate. And I have soaked the half cup of moong dal. Okay. Just add it in the plate. Just remove the water and just spread like this. Okay. Black and Kartik. Can you all see the video, right? See, I'm just taking in the plate and just spread it, okay?
Mataji, sorry to interrupt, but where did you learn all these like cooking things?
Sorry?
Sorry to interrupt, but where did you learn all these cooking like stuff?
These all from my parents and my some of from my devotee friends and some friends. Everybody taught me.
Okay, thank you, Mataji.
You're welcome. So take one carrot, peel it, and if you have not grated it, grate it, okay? You can use the bigger one, bigger size, whatever you have. You can take your parents' help. Yeah, you can just need 1/4 cup of this, okay? One carrot might be enough, I think. So, or 3/4, okay?
3/4.
This is nothing, just add everything, okay? I'm just taking carrots and adding on top of this layer, okay?
On top of the moong dal, right?
Yes, yeah. See, like this. just try to spread it. Okay, in the meantime, you can add all this vegetables, whatever you have. You can add whatever like spinach if you want. You can add whatever if you feel like adding some other vegetables to look more colorful, you can add. Okay. Mama, just add some cucumber. See, I have cut it in the small pieces. If you want, you can peel it or you can just use like that.
Mataji, can I say something?
Can you?
We don't have the ingredients, so can we do it someday?
Yes, you can do some other day.
Mataji,
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Mataji, we don't have cucumbers.
That's okay. Whatever you have, you can add. Okay?
Thank you.
It's not like... Okay. See, I'm just adding. Wherever you want, you can spread it. It's not like adding first carrot, then cucumber. What? Just whatever you want, you can add. Okay? See, first moong dal, carrot, cucumber. Okay? And then I'm adding some coconut. These are all, it looks colorful also, okay? See, okay? Shall I wait for somebody?
Mataji, the coconut looks like white cheese.
Yeah, right? Grated paneer or cheese. You're right, Chandra.
Yes? Mataji, the cucumber looks like big pieces of cheese, and also the carrot looks like red cheese. Like
Yeah. You have to think all like cheese and offer to Krishna and eat it, okay?
Mataji, are we supposed to put cheese right now?
No. There's no
cheese. No, we are not using any cheese. They look like cheese, they are saying, Jagannath.
Yeah. Oh, Mataji, I'm getting confused.
Okay. No. They're saying like coconut and these pieces look like cheese pieces and these look like grated cheese, mozzarella cheese or something like that. So we are not adding any cheese in this, okay?
We are just saying, Mataji.
Sorry, we are just... And then I'm adding coconut, coriander leaves. Wash them nicely.
Did you have a question?
Yes.
Instead of like putting like that, like covering them, like can we just put all them in like a bowl?
Yeah. You can add in the bowl, and however we'll be mixing it, we'll add salt and everything, right? I'm just showing the layer wise this. If you want, you can just keep it in the layer wise, or you can just mix it everything. In the bowl or whatever way, it's not like only using in the plate. You can add, you can mix it also, okay? And then next step is we'll be adding salt at last, okay? If you have some nuts, you can have. This is an optional. This is also an optional. If you want, you can use. I'm just using some cashew.
Is coconut optional?
Yeah, if you have, you can use. That looks, the taste will be nice. If you don't have, you can skip it, okay? And then add some pepper.
Mataji, okay. Yours looks really yummy.
Yummy? Yeah, so colorful, right? Yeah, even I'm also liking it.
Instead of grated coconut, can we do like the hardened coconut oil?
Coconut oil, you're saying?
Like when it's like hardened, like into big chunks.
If you want like pieces thing, you can add those also. Yeah, cheng things also, like not too big. Okay, then I'm adding some pepper. this is very little you can add, okay? Or not, you can skip it also if you don't want pepper. Okay? I just made the fresh pepper, grinded it, and I'm just using that powder. Okay? Then I'm using some nuts. I'm using some raisins, cashew nuts, and some badam. So it's not like only this, you can use anything, whatever you want, okay? Spread it evenly. I think so. You can't see them, but okay. Next step is like take a small slice of lemon, half, cut it into half. You can ask your parents to cut it for you. You can use the squeezer, or just if you want, you can use your hand. Okay. See, I'm squeezing it. You can mix it. If you want anything more also, you can add it. If you feel like you want to add more carrots, you can add it now. You feel you have more moong dal, less vegetables, then add those also.
Can we add other vegetables like seeds or anything?
Yes, whatever you want, you can add. If don't add too many big pieces, make them small pieces, or those vegetables are a little bit hard, you can grate them also. If carrot like pieces, then grating that looks nice, right? So it's easy. So carrots and cucumber also, you can grate it. If you grate it, it will be more juicy. So for cucumber, I'm just using the pieces. You can add spinach. Yes, Mataji.
Radhika Mataji. Yeah, Mataji. Yes, Mataji. You can let them know that this recipe is also made on Janmashtami as
yes,
a special
Mataji.
Offering
yeah.
in some part of India. This, yeah. yeah, we got this recipe from a cooking group, and okay. in that part, they had mentioned that it is also made during Janmashtami.
Janmashtami. Yeah, yeah. Thank you, Mataji, for letting me. So did you all hear, right? So Mataji was saying this is specially used in India for in some of the places. They'll be using for this a special offering for Lord Krishna on Janmashtami. And this is very nutritious also. You can make it very easily, and specially nowadays we came to know right now. So we'll also offer for Janmashtami. Okay?
Yes, Mataji.
And this recipe is from some of the cooking, like Krishna cooking recipes they'll be sending. So this recipe, Mataji have shared. So I'm just showing you this, okay? So at last, you can add salt when you are serving. So if you feel like you have done with everything, then at last you can add salt, okay? Can you all see this?
Almost done. Just need
okay.
Looks like salt. Mataji, I'm done.
You're done? You can
yeah.
add salt. Spoon to me.
And Mataji, I also put jackfruits.
Jackfruits, yeah. You can add like pomegranate seeds also. They also look colorful.
Mataji,
I just got some idea.
Mataji,
nice, Jagannath. I can't see the board.
Like, Mataji, I mean dry fruits.
Dry fruits? Oh,
yeah.
Nice.
Can we add pomegranate seeds?
Yeah, if you have, you can add. I can see Harini making Jagannath is done. Jagannath and Dina Krishna. It looks nice, Jagannath. So nice.
Thank you, Mataji.
You're welcome. Harini is making. Mokshita, are you done?
Yes.
Did you add pomegranate seeds also?
No, I didn't. I just asked if we can.
Okay, okay.
I swear. Oh my God.
Radhika Mataji?
Yes, Mataji.
Dina Krishna wants to show you.
Okay, Mataji. Show Dina Krishna. Oh, nice. One ball for you and one ball for Jagannath. Very nice.
Thank you,
Mataji.
You're welcome. Thank you so much for making.
Okay.
Yeah, Mataji.
Yeah, because bhajan class kids have joined.
Yes, yes, Mataji. Sure. Yeah.
Sorry, Mataji.
Thank you so much for all the kids. Vancha Kalpata Rubyasya Kupa Sindhu Vyai Vacha Patindhu Vyai Vacha Patita Nam Bhavu Nebhyo Vaishya Vibhyo Namo. Hare Krishna, everybody. You can post in the group, okay? Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Thank you very much, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Thank you for your class, Mataji.
Thank you.